Story time, bitch.
If you a young child and you know you're a young child, if you're not old enough to have a driver's license, basically, go get your parental permission to watch this because it's going to be about drugs, all right? Just a little gist of where we're at. Me and my man's TJ, we're in California with both of our girlfriends. And at the time, me and my girl are kind of going through a little thing right now, so we're kind of arguing. And she decided she was going to stay at her friend's house. So me and TJ decide we're going to go to Venice Beach. And somewhere along the lines, TJ decides he wants to do some shrooms. So he's like, yo, let's do some shrooms. From what I know, I'm like, yo, I know you have to be in a positive mindset with positive people and a positive environment for shrooms to really feel good. I know if you're not, you're gonna have a bad time. I'm like, I don't know about all that. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if I'm gonna do all that. Me and my girl arguing right now. I feel a little down. I'm not sure if shrooms is the best idea. He's like, bro, come on, let's do some shrooms. You know how peer pressure is. So I got the devil and the angel on my shoulder, you know what I'm saying? The angel's like, you know, chill out, bro. Like, this ain't right. You know what I'm saying? Like, something like that. I don't know. It wouldn't be too responsible of you to do shrooms. You know what I'm saying? The devil's like, fuck all that, bro. Like, I'm trying to trip nutsack. Take the shrooms. Eat the shrooms. Have a good time. And so they arguing. I really don't know. I'm kind of worried about it. That's what I'm saying, you know? I don't know if I'm ready for all that. Let's do the shrooms, bruh. Let's do the shrooms. I don't know if this is the best idea. You're gonna have a bad time. Fuck that. Fuck that. We ain't... Fuck all that pussy shit. You know, as all my good stories start, I look up. I'm like, bet. I'm not no bitch, right? Fuck it then, let's do some mushrooms. Fuck it, let's do it. Fuck it. Now, when I said all that, in the back of my mind, I'm thinking, we're in Venice Beach. Like, we don't know nobody out here. We're not gonna be able to find no shrooms. TJ scoped out this dude who had a skateboard and long hair. And he fits the description, you know what I'm saying? I don't know how the conversation was going, but I know I was like, ain't no way in hell this dude don't think TJ a cop. Excuse me. Bro, let me talk to you. You got any mushroom? I don't think that's gonna work, bruh. I really don't. I was wrong. TJ walked right on up to this dude. He's like, go to the location. I'ma skate around for a little bit. In about an hour, text me and say that the pizza's here. So I'm like, fuck. We got about an hour to kill. He was like, yeah, come in an hour. I'm gonna go skateboard for a little while. And in the hour, I'm talking to TJ. I'm like, hey, bro. We need some kind of outline. We need some kind of agenda, a schedule for how the night is gonna go. Cause I don't know if you know this, but shrooms last about 8 hours, right? And it's like 8 o'clock right now. So we kind of gotta have like a plan or like an outline to the night. Like, how's it gonna go? TJ's like, you want an outline? Here's the outline. We're gonna eat them and then we're gonna have a good time, right? Shit, that sound like a pretty solid plan.
That sound pretty good. All right, bet then. Let's do it. Let's do it then.
So an hour go by, we eat fruit and shit. We go to the spot, we text the dude, pizza's here, and he's like, he's a sketchball. He's like, come inside.
And I'm kind of anxious about it until I stepped in this dude's apartment.
He's got like holographic paintings and just trippy ass pictures all over the wall. I'm like, just thinking like, oh yeah, this is the right guy.
Yo, this is the guy. Like, if this is definitely the guy to get it from. Obviously, we can't be driving while we're tripping, so we gotta go somewhere and park. So we decide Hollywood Boulevard is where we're gonna go, right?
So we go to 7-Eleven and get some chips to eat them with, and we figure we eat them now. By the time we get there and park and everything, they should be just starting to kick in while we're walking around. We eat them, and as we're leaving, somebody start beeping at TJ, and he get distracted and back right up into a pole, bust the tail light. Oh my God. Oh my God. This your girlfriend's car. Oh my God. If this ain't a sign that we about to have a bad time, hey, let's go. Forget this ever happened. We don't say nothing to nobody, all right? We already ate them. We in it now. We in this. We can't, ain't no turning back now. So fuck it. Let's go. Let's do it. So boom, we go to Hollywood Boulevard. We walking around and it just start kicking in. Just as we had planned. Honestly, guys, it was probably one of like the best experiences of my life. Like, everything just
moving, going crazy on me. Oh my God, I won't feel this way forever. I feel so good right now. I hope this never go away. I hope this lasts forever. I'm on such a spiritual endeavor right now. I feel like I could travel anywhere in my mind. Oh yeah, this is so cool. Oh my God. Wow, bro, everything is so vibrant. I have never seen colors this colorful before. Oh my God. I love it.
It's like a hard feeling to describe. Like basically, whatever you're feeling and thinking is like times 100 and you're just feeling that, whatever that is. Let you know, like I said, me and my girl are arguing at the time. Like I said, she's staying at a friend's house and she happened to be staying on Hollywood Boulevard. Now I knew she was in the area, but I didn't know she was right where we were. Watching my location and of course she's thinking like, what the hell is he doing here? Like, why is he all the places in LA and he's right outside of our apartment. But in my mind, I'm just like, this is the brightest spot in LA. Like, this is the best spot in LA to be. This is where all the lights is at. So she texts me. She's like, what are you doing? I'm like, nothing. We just walking down Hollywood Boulevard. We're walking back and forth this spot for like 2 hours. We didn't tell him we was tripping or anything. We didn't say nothing about that. So it makes no sense to them why we just walking back and forth on Hollywood Boulevard for 2 hours. And I could sense the attitude in the text. I'm like, man, something wrong. She's like, why? And I'm like, oh, fuck. I don't know. Like, just chilling, you know what I'm saying? Having a good time and shit. About 20 minutes go by and they pass us in the car. What the fuck is going on? We felt like children that just got caught doing something bad by their mother. Oh fuck, like they know. Why the hell did they just pass us? What the hell are they doing? Why are they stalking us? What the fuck do they want? They know, bro. They know about it. They know. That is where the downward spiral started. And we just started having a really bad time. Because now we start overthinking everything. We're like, why is they stalking our location? You know what I'm saying? So we go back to the car and we're sitting in the dark. And we started realizing that there's no way out of this. Like, we're pretty much in here. You know what I'm saying? Bro, this is when I tell you, like, shit just started feeling so bad. I can't even explain the feeling that I had. It was just emptiness. It was just an empty, solo dolo feeling. Like, bro, I feel so dark and empty and alone, and I just want to be home, bro. We can't drive back home, and we're gonna be on this for like another 6 hours, so we gotta figure out something. And this is what pisses me off, because I knew it too. I asked for the outline. What's the outline for the night? It was like, oh, we're gonna have a good time. Fuck, I don't want to do this no more, and we can't stop now. We in this. We stuck for 6 more hours. Somebody make the executive decision. We're like, yo, we got to call them. We got to call them. We got to tell them what happened. We got to tell them we're tripping and hope that they're very comforting and hope that they make this better. Yo, I already know. Me and my girl arguing. Like, I know she not going to be happy. This is not going to get no better. This is going to get worse for us because this was pretty irresponsible of me, especially the time we were in. We was arguing and everything. We weren't that good. I didn't tell her and all that. They gonna pick us up, and it's not about to get no better for me. We don't really say much, but I know she mad, and I'm just trying to explain to her that I don't feel good, and now's not the time. We drove separately. I'm driving with my girlfriend, and he riding with his girlfriend, and we're going home. So boom, we get back to the place. TJ and his girl walk in, and they happy as can be. He having a great time again, and I'm like, something ain't right. I'm like, bro, what she say about you crashing the car? Why she being so cool? And he was like, oh, I didn't tell her that. I didn't say nothing about that. I'm like, what? What you mean? No wonder ain't nothing wrong with you. You ain't faced none of your responsibilities. You still in the hole. You digging yourself deeper. I'm not, yo, that clock be ringing on the hour every hour. Fucking on my story. I'll wait. So, but that's none of my business. I'm not no snitch, right? Not my girl, not my car, not my problem. I got a spiritual journey I need to get back to, if y'all don't mind. My girl went back to her friend's house, and after she left, at first, I'm sitting here just feeling so lonely and bad and everything. How could she leave me like this? You know what I'm saying? Like, obviously, I'm having a bad time. How's she not gonna be here for me? You know what I'm saying? I just,
I really found myself. Like, I really...
It was like a little switch just went off in my head, and I was like, you know what? I don't even give a fuck.
I don't even care. All the emptiness just went away. It turned into just a full feeling.
Everything that I had inside of me, just, I just let it go. Back of my, I'm so happy. Clap along if you be. That was pretty much my whole experience. It was pretty great, honestly. I can't complain about it. It was pretty amazing. So, there you go. We were sitting there watching Shrek, and I just remember like looking out the window and just thinking like, man, I hope I feel this good for the rest of my life. It was great, honestly. All in all, it was great.
I recommend shrooms to like everybody, for real. You can
might as well just try it. Hey, what? If you ain't never tried it, you might as well. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to encourage anybody to do nothing they don't want to do. But if it's something you was just thinking about, like, oh, maybe I should try that. Hey, I'm just telling y'all I had a good time. And it's pretty much my experience.